was great fun to watch your speech. I'm a cat lover, so I love cats. And I had an inkling that that's what you were going to talk about. But I've got a female in my life, too, other than my wife. And so I can relate to you. So immediately, just you starting out with that, and I like the picture. We can visualize this cat that you're so close to. So I think that was a really nice touch. It could be something maybe, I mean, it could be tough to pass around without distracting. I guess one recommendation, maybe put it up here, but anyway, I liked it. I thought it was fun. And I just really enjoyed the tone of your speech. It was very relaxed. You're up here very comfortable. You're looking around at everybody. It's sort of a conversation, like something you might tell a friend about, you know, your favorite cat. So I like that aspect. You started off with it by making an analogy with like a female, like other than your wife. I thought that was pretty funny, like clever joke. I liked your gestures, and everything was pretty expansive. I know sometimes people have a tendency to go like this, but you are pretty expansive with them. And I liked how you'd be like, oh, I'm going to poke the cat, or, you know, you're even kind of reaching out here, which I know drew my attention, because immediately, like, when somebody starts coming towards you, you notice that. So I like that, to grab people's attention. And you didn't stand right up on here. You were pretty relaxed, kind of moving around a little bit, and some animation. So I like that aspect. Good vocal variety, good tone, nice and loud. Your gestures were good, but there was a few points where I noticed you had sort of this nervous thing like that. Like, I wouldn't do that because then I'm starting to look at your fingers. The structure was good. You had this fun introduction. Maybe you could expand the conclusion a little bit more. I don't know, make something fun or broaden it out. I mean, you do have this furry bundle of joy, but maybe there's another big, you know, big final joke you could throw in there to really grab people and get the attention. I just love this, the whole tone of it, but yeah, maybe a little bit more humor, and I think you'll have a wonderful speech.
One thing that I noted that was another good, I found to be a very good and not distracting, was you seemed to pause to gather your thoughts, but you didn't fill it with the bridge words or, you know, to go ahead and or the ah. It was just a natural, you went ahead and did that. You had the pictures, the visual aids. I think if you were to do that speech as a visual aid, you might want to have a few more photos and then pass them around as a humorous speech. It was fine. We learned, another one of the gestures is when you were doing the cat's fur and describing that. So you might want to also bring in, another tip would be to bring in with your wife and what her relationship is with the cat, to involve on it if it's humor, if she has that same relationship, or if it's you that has the special one. So all in all, I think it was a great speech. I enjoyed it. It was very entertaining. We know the perfect examples of the cat's personality. And thank you for sharing it with us today.
Thank you. Well, at this time, we're going to go ahead and give you all 2 minutes to fill out your evaluation contest ballot. And as a reminder, you have contestant number one, Eric, contestant number two, Pam. And go ahead and fill that out.